In this video, we're going to talk about a visual tool that's used in quantum computing to help better understand the state of qubits. This is known as the Bloch Sphere. Classical information, as we've talked about in class, can only have a value of 0 or 1. Quantum state can hold a value of superposition. And we can see that in the representation of quantum state here, where we have psi is equal to alpha ket 0 plus beta ket 1. So we have a linear combination of both of these states, 0 and 1, that before measurement, we can be in both states in a sense. After measurement, however, we collapse to either 0 or 1, and all quantum properties of that state, the superposition, is lost. So how would we go about visually representing a single bit or a qubit? Let's start with the bit. So if we're looking at the classical bit, we only have two states, 0 and 1. We can represent those as endpoints of a line. And we can't be in any state in between. We're just at the top at 0 or the bottom at 1. The qubit, however, is a little bit different. If only superposition was what we were worried about with quantum state, we could represent that in a 2D space. Quantum information, however, includes a phase aspect. And that's powerful because it constructively and deconstructively interferes to create powerful quantum computations. In order to represent that, we have a third dimension that we include in the Bloch sphere. So because we can be in any superposition of 0 and 1 with a phase aspect, we can have any state of a qubit represented as a point on the surface of this Bloch sphere. And something to note, the sphere has a radius of 1. So let's look at a couple of states on the Bloch sphere. If we're looking at our state ket 0, that would just be the top of the Bloch sphere, the north pole. If we're looking at the state ket 1, that would be the south pole of the Bloch sphere. So once again, if we're representing these states, we have 100% chance of being in 0, in this case to the left, and then 100% chance of being in state 1, in this case to the right. We can see that the plus state formed by the equal superposition of ket 0 and ket 1 is at the front point of the Bloch sphere. And our superposition state with phase, so we have this negative sign appearing next to the ket 1, that appears on the x-axis going to the back of the Bloch sphere. So something to note, a very important note, that whenever you rest on the equator of the Bloch sphere, that results in a 50-50 chance of being observed in either state 0 or state 1, ket 0, ket 1, respectively. How do single qubit operations appear on the Bloch sphere? Well, we've learned about a couple of different gates, so let's start with the not operation. Remember, the not operation takes a qubit and swaps the value, the probability amplitudes associated with ket 0 and ket 1. So let's think about not 0. Well, we know that that equals ket 1. So if we start at ket 0, we not it, we are left with a ket 1. Now let's not that ket 1. It results in a ket 0. We can see when we implemented that gate on the Bloch sphere, we ended up getting an x-axis rotation. So to be exact, a rotation around the x-axis of pi, or 180 degrees. So we also call the not gate a x gate because of that. So we also learned about the h gate. The h gate is what we use to put a qubit into a state of equal superposition. If we start with ket 0, we have our superposition state without phase. So start with ket 0. We end up going to the plus state. If we have an H gate with an input of ket 1, that's going to result in the superposition state with phase, so that negative sign next to that ket 1. The H gate implements a rotation of pi over 2 around the y-axis of the Bloch sphere. So if we saw that, we moved from ket 0 to the positive state, the positive superposition state, and ket 1 to the negative superposition state. So both y-axis rotations around the Bloch sphere. So to just kind of review, any point on the surface of the sphere represents a qubit state. Because we have that requirement for quantum state that we have to be in one of these two states with 100% chance probability, we have that requirement that alpha magnitude squared plus beta magnitude squared is equal to 1. And because of that, our radius is equal to 1. Remember, we can look back to our spherical and Cartesian coordinate conversions to confirm that our radius is equal to 1. We've talked about many single qubit quantum operations, and what these do is implement rotations along the Bloch sphere, and that's how they transform the state of a qubit. So to summarize, what we actually have happening to change the qubit state is that we have theta and phi change to cause those rotations.